Hello everybody, my name is Anmol Birring. Today is April the 11th, 2024. And today's topic is reference level, distance amplitude correction curve, and acceptance criteria. Now they are all linked together whenever we do ultrasonic testing. When we are doing ultrasonic testing, the focus of the technicians is to find discontinuities. Their focus is to do the inspection and find the discontinuities in the component or the part. Now, basically, every component or a part will have discontinuities. So the next step is, are these discontinuities acceptable or rejectable? You know, we don't reject every part. There is a rejection threshold that we only reject parts which are above that threshold. So the specification to which you are doing the inspection will define the acceptance criteria. So for example, let's take one case here. For this lecture, I will give you an example of an acceptance criteria. Let's say we are doing weld inspection for piping. And in this case, the acceptance criteria is reject discontinuities if they exceed the reference level and the length exceeds 3/8 of an inch or 9.5 millimeter. So we will only reject a discontinuity if it exceeds the reference level and exceeds the length exceeds 3/8 of an inch or 9.5 millimeter. Now here the question is, what is the reference level? The reference level is the amplitude of the signal which is established on the reference reflectors. And the reference reflectors are defined by the code. For piping, if you're doing ASME piping, then in that case, it will be 10% ID and OD notches to set up the reference level. So reference level is established on reference reflectors. For angle beam inspection of welds, it will be notches or sidereal holes. For straight beam inspections, it will be flat bottom holes. So how do we set up the reference level on these reference reflectors? So as an example, I took a case of pipe inspection, and here we use 10% ID and 10% OD notch. So this is like the pipe thickness, and ID notch 10% and a 10% OD notch. So the first step to set up the DAC curve or the reference level is to move the probe to the ID notch and peak up the signal, like it's shown here, ID notch, peak up the signal and then adjust the gain to make it 80%. So if the signal is below 80%, then you increase the gain. If it's above 80%, then you reduce the gain. You bring it down to adjust the gain so that it's 80%, which is shown here. This is for the ID notch, which is right here. Then move the probe back and go to the OD notch and then find the amplitude here and then connect these two dots, the ID notch and the OD notch, connect their peak points, and that becomes your distance amplitude correction curve. Now, what is the distance amplitude correction curve? Distance amplitude correction curve compensates for the beam spread of the ultrasonic probe. The ultrasonic probe is not like a laser beam that you'll get the same amplitude for all the sound paths. As the sound path increases, the beam spread increases, and with the increase in the beam spread, the amplitude will drop. So we have to compensate for that. So DAC means distance amplitude correction to compensate for beam spread. Now remember, the beam spread will change from probe to probe. If you are using a small probe, the beam spread will be higher. If you are using a lower frequency, the beam spread will be higher. And if the beam spread is higher, the drop in the DAC will also be higher. Now, this DAC, which is established on the reference reflectors, which is the 10% ID notch and the OD notch, that becomes our reference level. So that is how we define the reference level, which actually gets connected to the acceptance criteria. So this is our reference level now, which is the DAC, on the reference reflectors. And then after we had, after we get the DAC curve here, then we start doing the inspection. So now I have an example of a weld where we find two discontinuities. We have a discontinuity A and we have a discontinuity B. Now discontinuity A produces a signal A here, which let's say is 65% of the full screen height. But this signal is below the DAC curve or below the reference level. So if this signal is below the reference level, would you accept it or reject it? Well, the acceptance criteria says that the discontinuity has to exceed the reference level. So this 65% signal from A will actually be accepted because it is below the reference level. Then we are scanning with the probe and we go to discontinuity B, and the discontinuity B has a signal which is, let's say, about here, and which is say 55%. Now discontinuity C, signal B, 55%, is smaller than the discontinuity A signal, which is 65%, but the discontinuity B signal exceeds the reference level. So even though the signal is smaller, it actually exceeds the blue line, which is the reference level. So now once it exceeds the reference level, then we have to measure the length, and the length has to exceed 9.5 millimeters. Now we go to discontinuity B and we peak the probe signal here. Wherever it peaks, we move it to the left, we move it to the right, and look for the 6 dB drop points. 6 dB drop points means where the signal drops to 50% of the peak, and we mark these two points here and here, and that becomes our 6 dB drop points, and the spacing between that, we measure it as we move the probe from here to there, and let's say it measures 0.6 inches or 15 millimeter long. Now here, would you accept it or reject it? This signal from this B has exceeded the reference level, and the length has exceeded the acceptance criteria, the reject level. So it actually exceeds the reference level, and the length exceeds the this level here, 9.5 millimeter. So this signal, or the discontinuity B, will be a reject. What I wanted to show you was that you don't go by the amplitude of the signal, the absolute amplitude. You have to go by the relative amplitude of the signal relative to the reference level. So in this example, what we have shown that signal B smaller than signal A is actually a reject, while A, which is larger than B, is an accept because it is below the reference level. So make sure that we compare these signals to the reference level. I've run into situations where we have very good technicians who are doing the job. They find the discontinuities, they record them, and then after that they don't know what to do, whether to accept it or reject it. So this lecture is kind of focused for that subject, on what, on the last step, which is not the last step, which is the most important step, and that's the reason we do the inspection. We just don't do the inspection to find discontinuities only. We have to apply the acceptance criteria on the discontinuities to find out if they're acceptable or rejectable. That's the goal of the NDT inspections, is to see if the part can be accepted or it is a rejected part. And thank you very much. And in the next lecture, I will do a demonstration of this DAC on an actual UT machine to show you how it is done. It's very simple, and we'll do it in the next lecture shortly. Thank you so much.